What's up, y'all? It's me, Daria, coach of the Minneapolis Meow Sagradas, and we are here for week 5 of the PPL. This week, we are up against Razorclaw. We have our work cut out for us. We are trying to stay undefeated. We're 4-0 so far. This is going to be a really tough test of that. Razor is an incredible team builder, very creative. I'm a big fan of his creative team building, just straight up. If you haven't watched his battles yet, please go check out his channel. Again, he has built some super spicy fucking sets for some of his battles this year, so far, or this season, whatever. And I am excited to see what he has come up with for us. He's got a team. He's got some threats for sure. I'll get the team up on the screen, but he has a Cinderace, which is always scary. Sandy Shocks, which I think is pretty underrated in most leagues. Politoed, I love a good frog, but I don't think he brings weather because bringing weather against my team is crazy because my Zapdos just wrecks him if he does that. Pheasant Dippity can be kind of spooky. He ran this cool Swords Dance Technician set with Quick Attack, which just kind of dunked on people. So that is something that we need to be aware of. Pink Kerchin can be annoying. Although terrain does help our iron treads, so wouldn't hate to see the pink urchin, or the Politoed for that matter. Bronzong, I am a big Bronzong fan as well. I think Bronzong is horribly underrated in most leagues. Chestnut can be annoying. Hydreigon is a Hydreigon, it's always a threat. Tornadus can be pretty annoying as well. Trevenant is one of his Terra Captains. Pink urchin and Trevenant as his Terra Captains I think are interesting. I don't know. I guess I'll... I don't want to like disrespect them in any way, because whenever I disrespect a Pokemon in my team builder, I like end up losing to that Pokemon. So I'm not gonna shade them in any way. But like, I don't see me losing to Trevenant. It could happen, like maybe a weird Trick Room set, or maybe like some kind of like bizarre like Harvest set or something like that. Snorlax can be annoying as well, and Golduck. I have lost to a Golduck before, so like Golduck is also something not to sleep on. All that being said, I think I have a decent team prepared for him. Let's talk about it. So basically the idea with this team is that we want to get screens up with Mesprit, who has Light Clay. We also have Rocks. Maybe we can get those up at some point. But really, the important thing with Mesprit here is to get up screens and grab some momentum, and try to set up our offensive threats, which in this match will be the Zapdos, Iron Treads, and Meowscarada. My hope with the Zapdos, which is a weakness policy set, is that I can get it in safely with like a Reflector Light Screen up, U-turn into it, and pop a weakness policy. Maybe bait a Rock move from like a Sandy Shocks, or a Chestnut, or even like a a Bronzong. If we can bait some type of Rock move, and then go +2 with our special attack, and then the Hurricanes, Thunderbolts, and Heat Waves aren't going to feel good. It pretty much covers everything on this team. We will need chip on things in order to actually win with this. So I don't think the goal is to win with Zapdos as much as it's just to kind of like pressure and kind of break through. I think Booster Energy Iron Treads can also apply a lot of pressure. What we're trying to do is set up so that Meowscarada can come in and just win in the end, like we've been doing all season. Iron Treads is a Booster Energy set. First time I've ran Booster Energy on it this season. It's actually going to be Booster Energy with attack boosting. We're going to try and rely on the Rapid Spin to get our speed up. We might come back on this later and regret it, because we do not like outspeed the Sandy Shocks now without a Rapid Spin, which could be a tremendous oversight on my part. I just like, we can boost our speed with a setup. We cannot boost our attack. So I really wanted to get that attack boost from the Booster Energy. That way the Earthquake knockoff and Ice Spinner, which basically covers everything on the team, is going to be hitting everything really hard. Again, trying to set up for a late game Meowscarada clean with Flower Trick, Play Rough, Knock Off, and Low Kick. Again, pretty much covers the entire team. Then there's Dondozo. Dondozo is the obvious Cinderace switch-in. Because it is the obvious Cinderace switch-in, it means he's going to have counterplay for it. I believe the counterplay for this Cinderace will be one of two things. He'll either just click U-turn, which, yeah, okay, that makes sense, and then go into something like Sandy Shocks to threaten it out. Or he'll run a weird like flame charge electro ball set like we've seen him run earlier this season. Either way, we have a Whackenberry, Wakanberry, Weigainberry, whatever you want to fucking call it. We have it. It's going to reduce an electric attack. It's going to let us tank an electric attack and either click Earthquake wave crash. And if we really want to get spicy, we can Yawn Protect and try to put things to sleep and just be generally annoying. This thing is really just here for the physical attackers, mostly just so I don't lose the Cinderace. And then finally, Volbeat is making a return. We're not using it to set rain or any other kind of weather, surprisingly enough. We're just using it to encore things and be annoying, roost and U-turn and fire off some fire terror blasts. This thing could actually be pretty disruptive for his team. But yeah, that's our team. I think we have the stuff here to do it. Maybe not as spicy as we have been previous weeks. I guess weakness policy, agility, Zapdos is not super common, so it would be really cool if we could like win or punch a hole with that. Whackenberry Dendozo, I guess, is also kind of neat. But aside from that, I think we have some pretty standard sets, but sets that can help us win. I know he's going to bring something crazy, so we'll just have to go into the battle with an open mind and just be prepared for anything. So hopefully we can finish this week at 5-0. But if we lose, like, hey, we had a really, really good start to the season, and I'm not ashamed or embarrassed or anything. Like, I feel like I came into this league, no one really knew who I was, and I won my first 4 games. So I feel like that is something to be proud of in and of itself. So, yeah, I guess now we're just going to wait for Razor to be ready for the battle. It's one in the morning here, by the way. I'm kind of a night owl, so it's not a big deal. I'm a little sleepy, but it's not too bad. But yeah, we're just waiting for Razor, and yeah, I'll be back when he's ready. All right, y'all, we're back. Searching for Razor now. Yeah. It's 2 in the morning, so I'm just a little low energy, but we should be good. I don't work tomorrow or anything, so it's not a big deal. Like, I agreed beforehand with Razor, and I told him we could battle between like 2 or 3 and it wouldn't be a problem, so I brought this upon myself. I probably should have had like a coffee or something, but we'll be okay. All right, good luck, have fun. I could lead this and just try to get up my rocks or screens on turn one, but I don't like that. I like the idea of applying pressure on turn one more, so I do think I'm going to lead with Meowscarada. That doesn't mean I have to click anything. That doesn't mean I have to click anything. So we'll play it by ear here, but I do prefer to do a bit of a more offensive lead typically. I find that when I lead with passive leads to try and set up hazards, that is often when I get myself in trouble. I mean, I'm gonna be bad. This is a free knockoff. I'm just gonna click knockoff. I'll just take my free knockoff. I do reveal Protean, which, yeah, obviously I'm Protean. All right, so that was Rocky Helmet. This was the Meowscarada swap in. Yeah, I don't really have a way to touch this thing with Meow. I'm gonna go into this, because if they do try to like set up or something, then I can just lock it in with Encore, or if it's like sub. Okay, so he just goes for the double kick. Pennywise eats it up, because of course it does. Okay, so we see double kick. It's probably Technician. I doubt it's Toxic Chain. Yeah, I think I'm gonna Terra and U-turn. Get my Terra off, and then... Yeah, that seems good, right? That seems fine. He stays in. I'm assuming he clicks, like, flying move? Like, probably, like, Brave Bird or something? Honestly, like, I don't, like, what's his plan with this? Dunk shot. Okay. Yeah, I mean, that hurt. That didn't feel good. But we know we outspeed this. I could just go right into this right now. I could go into this now. I don't like the idea of taking chip on this. I think I have to go into this now, which sucks, but this could actually outspeed me because of the investment in my fucking iron treads. I fucking knew I should have went more speed on my treads. Like, if it's max speed, it outspeeds me. I could just fire off an EQ here. In fact, I think I will. I think I will EQ. Or I could just yawn. I think damage is good, though. I think damage is better. But we've seen double kick and gunk shot on this. I'll take EQ damage on this Golduck. That did nothing. Golduck is leftovers. Okay. I don't just yawn this thing, do I? Like, no, because this could grass knot me, and that would be less than ideal. I think maybe I go into Knuckles now. I think this is probably special. I think I'd probably go into Knuckles now and try to, like, set up, like, a screen or something. And then I could, like, slow U-turn into, like, Meowscarada. Maybe even, honestly, this thing's probably packing Ice Beam. I could get up a light screen and try to slow U-turn into my, Zapdos and try to agility and bait like an ice move. That's an interesting option. This could also knock off though. So going into Mesprit might have been a misplay. I guess they could knock. But if this is his switch in, okay, he's gone. Okay, well now he knows I'm Walking Berry, which fucking sucks. Trevenant can, like, poltergeist on me, which isn't great. But I for sure outspeed it. Maybe I just reflect. I think a screen is probably the correct option right now. Okay, so he is gonna go ahead and Terra this. It's Terra Ghost. A poltergeist is not gonna feel good, but I don't think it kills through reflect. It almost kills. I'll get up my light screen and just go down. Well, how are you hitting my Zapdos? Are you hitting Zapdos with a rock move? I'm gonna get up my light screen and go into Zapdos and click agility. Fuck it. I don't care. This thing can go down. I needed screens from this, and that's what I'm getting. I mean, I suppose I could also go into this and just click knockoff. But I think the better play, yeah, actually, I do think I go into this and I bait the switch and then go into Bird Mother. Although maybe I just go right into this. I should probably be running calcs, but I am too tired and I don't feel like doing that. So I'm just gonna go into this and I'm gonna double into Bird Mother, which might be a tremendous misplay, but I'm gonna do it anyways. Although I could just click knock off. I'm gonna double into Bird Mother. Cool. Let me catch that Buzzendipity. Yeah, I don't know. I'm gonna heat wave. Try to catch the Sandy Shocks. Okay, so here's the Sandy Shocks. So we'll get the heat wave off. And we'll miss. That checks out. We're gonna agility. See if they click power gem here. They light screen. I'm not doing shit to this then. That fucking sucks. All right, so it's almost certainly light clay. Yeah, I don't think this is gonna be the week, y'all. Fuck. This is bad. This is bad. And heat wave isn't gonna do anything because light screen's up. So I gotta go into this and I gotta click flower trick. Discharge. Oh, if I get paralyzed, I'm so fucked. Crit. And the para. A crit into a para. Okay. Fuck me. Whatever. Alright. Doesn't fucking matter. I've had pretty good RNG so far. I feel like maybe I've hacked some people out. So this was bound to happen. It doesn't matter. Honestly, let me just get this game over with. Show me the Fezzendipity, yeah. You'll take like 2 damage from my flower trick. At least I got the attack off. I mean, this shit is... It's over! No, I mean, I still have win cons here. I still have win cons. I need to chill. It looks really bad right now, but it's not over. That discharge crit into a para was very sad. Very, very sad. Cool. Well, they missed a gunk shot, so that's neat. I'm into that. I could just Terra Blast for some damage here. I'm gonna just Terra Blast just for some damage here. That's fine. That did nothing. Oh, you poor creature. You poor creature. I Terra Blast for more chip. And then I roost. And then I U-turn. Yeah, I gotta win with fucking Iron Treads now. So I gotta find my opportunity to click Rapid Spin. Roost. You might be fishing for like a poison or something. Oh, you also roost. Whatever, dude, I'll play this game. Into what? Sandy shocks. Okay. Okay, so lefties. Fuck. God, this is so bad. This is so bad. I think I have to go into this. I'm taking way too long on my turns, too. Yeah, show me the light screen. Oh, you set up spikes. Interesting. Okay. Let me just try to get some damage on this. Well, it's faster than my Zapdos, which actually is telling because my Zapdos has speed. It's got lots of speed. So if this thing is faster than my Zapdos, like, that is very telling. So it's almost certainly faster than my Iron Treads. I feel like just spamming Heat Wave like isn't accomplishing anything. I wish I knew what that other move was. If I could just I guess I gotta keep clicking Heat Wave. I could Agility, but I'm not gonna get my weakness policy to pop. I don't see a universe where that actually happens. I just fucking lose the Sandy Shocks. Whatever, I'm getting chip on it. I'm just gonna give this to you. I mean, I don't fucking, at this point, like, whatever. Doesn't matter. Okay. Well, I think I go mini now. Whatever, I'll just flower trick again. Who fucking cares? I needed to get Stealth Rocks up. That was probably way better than screens because the amount of pivoting he's doing. Like, and I'm fully fucking paired. Okay. Whatever. Okay, that's fine. Again. Poison. Yep, there it is. Knew it was coming. Here. Back into Sandy Shocks. Let's do this. Oh, you're into Golduck this time. Switching it up. Very cool. I don't fucking know. That thing ate the earthquake from this, so it might be really physically bulky. This might not even kill. Like, for real, like, this is just, like, such a joke. This is such a fucking joke. Alright. I'm taking, like, the full timer on every turn. Okay, Calm Mind. It's almost certainly Grass Knot. I'm gonna yawn. Show me Grass Knot. There it is. All right. I'm clicking Wave Crash. I'm just fucking clicking Wave Crash. He's not gonna leave this in. He's not gonna let it go to sleep. I'm clicking Wave Crash. Maybe I get enough chip to kill myself, and then I go into Iron Treads and try to make something happen from this miserable fucking experience. I am so sorry, y'all. I'm just like, see, it's 2:30 in the morning. I want to be done with this. I just want to move on to week 6 and just be done with this nightmare. Cool. I'll take lots of damage on this thing. Sure. I can't rapid spin against this, though. It's like the ironic thing. I didn't even fucking kill myself either. I'm gonna click Wave Crash again. I don't fucking care. Take this. I don't need it. I wonder if Meow outspeeds this, even paralyzed. The funny thing is, I think it does. I got nothing to say about this. I was underprepped for Pheasantipity. I think that's all I can really say here. I click flower trick. Click flower trick. Yeah, but yeah, that's the play. That's what else would you do? You just go into Pheasantipity every time. There's no reason to do anything else. Let's see. You know, do I get cheeky here and click Flower Trick again, trying to catch him, trying to catch me going into Volbeat? Sure, why not? If I die, I die. I don't care. Cool. Sorry, Minnie. This wasn't the week. Much as it pains me to admit. Do I just go for it? Do I just say fuck it? Just fucking shoot my shot? Do I love a double kick? I guess that's kind of what it comes down to, right? And it doesn't matter. I'm just gonna go into this and do it. I just want to be done with this. This has been miserable. A miserable fucking experience this was. Okay. They might go right to Trevenant to try and, like, block my spin. I don't care. I don't care. I'm over this. Sad thing is, maybe if I got Stealth Rocks up instead of screens with Mesprit, and I prioritized those instead of the screens. Like, who knows? Maybe I have a chance. And I also outsped this. Let's see if Double Kick kills me. No, not even fucking close. Okay. Is there any reason I don't just not Earthquake now? But he goes Bronzong all day, right? No, he lets me have a kill. That was very generous of you. Razor to let me have a kill. Very, very generous. All right, now show me Scarf, Cinderace, and just end my misery. All right, well, there's the Bronzong. It's surely Cold Barberry, right? Not Colbert. Body press. There's the body press. Cool. All right. Well, GG's. Sorry I didn't give you a better match. I don't know what else to say. I played like shit. I prepped like. We'll prep better and do better next week. God, it would have been so cool to get a kill with this thing. Thought we were cool. Guess not. Guess we're not friends. Just kidding. Okay. GG's gonna raise her. That's not cute. Not cute. GG's again. He said he built this team like last minute. Could have fucking fooled me. Wasn't even close. I didn't even give him a good battle. And for that, I do apologize. I'll be better prepped for next week.